Hey guys, today I will be going over how to recalibrate your Unverfirth Model 410 scale indicator. In order to optimize your scale's performance, your setup and or calibration number may need to be adjusted slightly. If your scale weight is consistently reading off compared to your loaded truck weight, then your calibration number may need to be altered for more accurate scale readings. You can find your grain cart setup and calibration number within your scales manual book. To recalibrate your scale, we recommend comparing your cart weight to a certified scale truck weight over several loads to create a large sample size. This will generate more accurate results. To calculate your calibration number, you can easily find it by using the calibration equation listed here. You will take your total certified weight divided by your total indicator weight, multiplied by the current calibration number on your scale, and that will give you your new calibration number. The first step to get to your calibration number is by turning your indicator on. You will then hold down the zero and the on-off button for 3 seconds. It will bring you to your setup page. The current number displayed is your predetermined factory setup number. To get to the calibration screen, all you have to do is click the on-off button and it will automatically bring you there. The current number displayed is your current calibration number that will be used in the equation. To get back to the normal scale menu, you just click the on-off button again. The total certified weight is found by collecting the weight of your loaded grain truck at a certified scale. To get your total indicator weight, you can find it by taking the weight that your grain cart scale reads within the tractor. You will then take the average over several loads to create a large sample size. Doing this will generate more accurate scale results. The total indicator weight of our first load displayed that there was 50,300 pounds. The grain cart was unloaded into a truck and brought to a certified scale. The grain of that load weighed 50,100 pounds. We then took a second sample where in our cart it displayed that there was 53,000 pounds. The second load was unloaded into the grain truck and brought to a certified scale. That load weighed 55,000 pounds. Our third load in our sample displayed that there was 57,000 pounds within our grain cart. The third load was unloaded into the grain truck and brought to a certified scale. That load weighed 61,000 pounds. We then added all three loads from the grain cart and the truck. The total indicator weight of the grain cart was 160,300 pounds. The total certified weight of our truck was 166,100 pounds. Now that we have our total certified weight and indicator weight, we can perform our calibration calculation. So we will take our total certified weight, which is 166,100 pounds, divide it by our total indicator weight, which was 160,300 pounds. We will multiply that by our current calibration number that we found, which was 40,800, and we will get our new calibration number of 42,276. We will then be able to put that in our scale, and our scale will be recalibrated. In order to enter our new calibration number, we will have to go to the same calibration menu screen like before. We will hold down the zero and the on-off button to bring us to our setup value, where that can be changed if you use the predetermined factory numbers. If you did the calculation, you will then click the on-off button to get to the calibration menu where your calibration number then can be changed. You will use the field button and the start-stop button. The field button will increase the value by 1. The start-stop button will move the digit being altered over 1. So for our number of 42,276, we will need this to be a 7, this to be a 2, this to be a 2, and then we can go all the way over and it'll just come back. If you go over your value, like in this case we needed a 6, don't worry, you can just go all the way back around. And then you can click the on-off button and it'll enter your calibration number. As you can see, on the indicator as well as the remote display. It changed our total weight value, and now our scale should be recalibrated.